Kristen, we got two Kristen here. And for me with circles, I'm going to go back. There was a place in my life, how many months have we been in this?
10 months,
okay. So I would say 11 months ago, I was thinking to myself, I was with my three kids, I was at home, and I said, what am I going to do? The best I can do is not enough. Literally, like, working is not enough. Whatever, it's just not enough. What am I going to do? And so I'm looking at my three children, and I'm aching inside, because I'm like, what am I going to do? I'm literally stuck, like, literally, like, literally. If you know the cycle of poverty, there is no way out. There, the way that it's set up, like the founder said, the way they set it up, there is no way out of it. It's a cycle. It keeps you in. It keeps you in. So I'm looking at my life and I'm saying, okay, I know that I'm smart. I know that I'm intelligent. I know that I'm a hard worker, but I'm stuck. So I said, okay. So long story short, I went to the mailbox and it was this sign up that was said something through the Greenville Housing Authority. It was called the Family Self-Sufficiency Program. If you were on public housing of any kind. So what happened was I called the lady, Ms. Newkirk, set up an appointment with her, and I started that program. Most people don't even know that low-income programs, they have programs available. That's one problem, too. The programs that's there, they don't advertise them. Nobody knows about them. Like, literally, I just walked to the mailbox, and there it was, and it just so happened I called her on the last day. So I started with that. That was the first step. And then I met Zelma. Well, I kind of knew Zelma already, and Zelma was telling me about circles. She was telling me about it for herself. I'm already in family self-sufficiency, so I didn't think, what do I need circles for, you know? So a lady called me and said, Crystal, do you know a place where I can get some help? I said, I heard about this program called Circles. Maybe you can call them and see what it's about. So I think I called Bruce to get information on it for someone else. And Bruce telling me about this program, and I'm like, I think I might. So I called my family self-sufficiency coordinator because I think you had to be, I don't know if you can sign up for it on your own, but someone had to refer you. So she did the paperwork and referred me. And what was so funny, when we were trying to get the application, she kept asking me, are you a leader or an ally? I don't think I'm a leader. So I'm filling out the ally information, and we like, well, that don't sound right. And so I recognized the reverse psychology. Yeah. I said, okay. So I did that, got in there, started the program, a little anxious about everything because, again, I'm stuck. I realized this. I got three kids, and I'm stuck. Divorce, no baby daddy around, no child support, it's just me. $9 an hour, it's not gonna get you nowhere. It's just not. So anyway, long story short, I get in, I get my allies, and I guess I start blossoming there, I guess, you know, because I always knew something was in me deeper. But with me, I've had to deal with low self-esteem. If a person beat me, they'll say, oh, you don't seem like that. But when you grew up in that circle, your grandmother was in it. Your mother was in it. Your father wasn't away, but when he was in your life, he was destructive. So my mother used to always tell me, you're nothing but the product of the product. My mother was on crack. She was a prostitute. She was a very unfit mother. My father, when I did get in his care, you know, sometimes you think a person selling their body and smoking crack on the street is worse. Get a functioning crackhead or drug addict.
They were.
So I go into a situation where, okay, I just left this dysfunction and now I'm in this dysfunction. And so then my dad, I'll never forget, he had a round table discussion with his three children. And he said, you know what? He looked at my brother Keith and he said, you know what? Keith is going to be better than all of y'all. So I'm 14, 13, 14, and I'm like, so you already saying I'm going to be nothing. And he looked at me and said, you know, you're just going to be just like your mother. I said, okay. Okay. So I go on, get married, dysfunction, and bad relationship choices. But as I got older, I realized, oh, this is a cycle. This is a cycle. And so it started with my children. I'm a homeschooler. I took them out because, sadly, even in the public school system, there's a cycle there with children in poverty. My oldest son, first kindergarten, something wrong with him. You need to put him in, you need to put him on medication. He needs to be on a plan. Okay. Battle with that. Then here come my daughter. Kindergarten, something wrong with her. She need to be in a special class. You need to put her on medication. So then I have my third child, daycare. You know, Crystal, they're gonna put him on medication. I'm done. No. But, so that was the start of me realizing that this cycle is so deep. Yes. It's like a pit that you cannot get out of. And again, going back to even like whatever you were saying in the class with Bruce, I thank God for Bruce. I like the element he brought because he was a white man in there.
Fix that, Bruce.
Yeah. Circle to change your life. So here's this white man in this colorful shirt I'm coming to every day. But that's when it hit me. I'm in trouble. As we're going through our lessons and stuff, and I'm learning about generational poverty and situational poverty. I'm learning about, it's like Emily said, that thriving versus surviving. And just this surviving mentality, and I'm like, oh my God, this has been my whole life. It's just surviving. I have to get out of this. So personally, inside, that's what I was struggling with. Like, wow, this is hitting me hard. Like, literally, I would go home and cry. Like, literally, you know, because I'm strong, you know. But no, I'm having battles on the inside. So again, I'm meeting wonderful people. I have wonderful allies. My ally's not here. He's a colonel in the military, and he's in California right now. But when me and him start talking, we like, wow. We're in the same situation. He's retired from the military, and he's realizing, wow, I've been dependent on the system. And then it's me, I'm trying to get out of this, transitioning, because we're both transitioning, I'm dependent on the system. So we were like a perfect match. So, you know, he'll call me, encourage me, and he'll call me and say, Crystal, thank you, you know. And it's been such a wonderful experience, and I've had other ones. But I've realized, to sum everything up, that there's more in me than I knew was there. It's like I knew it was there, but you have to be in the right situation to bring it to the surface. I feel like for me, this is time to grow up. Because again, what's happening with this cycle of poverty is that you have more people who can be beneficial to our society that are not. They're just wasting away. They're just wasting away. So, like I said, I'm with the Greenville Housing Authority and their Family Self-Sufficiency Program. I got lots of opportunity with them. I'm on the advisory board there, the resident advisory board. I got a job through there. It's a contract position, but I'm doing their cleaning classes where they're starting to, sadly, when you're in poverty, that also brings in depression. You don't care about your environment. And so what they're trying to change is that mindset of you're living here, but you're tearing up the property. So I'm the one that teaches them that. So now I'm in a position to give back, you know, to give back. And again, I already work for myself. I push myself to realize, okay, forget this managing poverty. That's another term I've learned in circles, managing poverty. No. I can do better than that. So I did complete a semester. I'm still going for my nursing degree at Greenville Tech. I've completed it. But I did go to college at one time. I graduated in 2007, and I graduated with honors. But if there's no one there to say, keep going, yes, to say, you can do this. How did I do that? I'm a first generation college graduate with honors. Wow. Obviously, I'm smart, obviously. But so, like I said, I'm Greenville Tech, and I'm, right now I'm working on a business plan. So I'm gonna be a business owner too. Yeah. And again, summing it all up, circles, it's making a difference in people's lives. We need to bridge that gap, like between the middle class and the people that are poor. We're not just here because we're dumb, we're lazier, or anything like that. It is literally a system that's set up to keep you down. But a program like Circles can help someone get out of that situation. Okay.